Over my last 12 years of consuming content on YouTube, I've seen video edits that have me scratching my head and thinking, man, that video could have been so much better if they had just done this or that. So in this video, I'm gonna help you avoid 5 editing mistakes that I see YouTubers make every day. The first mistake I see is YouTubers using long intros. Back in the day, everybody used intros on their videos, me included. If you haven't noticed, it's been a minute since I used the intro of my videos. Why is that, you ask? The opening moment in your video is the most important part of your video. This is when a viewer decides to keep watching or click away. If you have a long intro at the beginning of your video, you're not delivering value. My advice, don't use intros at all, just get rid of them. If you feel you have to have an intro for some reason, make sure it's no longer than 3 to 5 seconds. Next mistake is bad pacing. Pacing is one of the top tools used to keep your audience engaged. If your audience isn't engaged, they'll click away faster than a nun swiping left on a Tinder profile. Pacing can be improved using jump cuts. The jump cut is used to remove gaps or pauses when a person is talking, or to move quickly between a scene or different camera angles. All you need to do is place your cursor where you want, split the clip where you want, and then go ahead and delete that portion, fill the gap, and boom, you got yourself some jump cuts. Now let's talk about another old trend that's a huge mistake: asking for stuff at the beginning of the video. Yep, I fell victim to this trend. I used to ask for all kinds of stuff at the beginning of my videos. Before we get started, I want to remind you to subscribe. You want people to like, comment, and subscribe based on the value of the content. And the best way to do this is to get to the content as quickly as possible. While you're asking people to do all the stuff you want them to do, they're asking you to get to the content. The viewer is there for whatever your title and thumbnail told them that they would get, not for you to ask them for a bunch of favors. If you still feel that you want to give the viewer a reminder, using a visual graphic or call out during the video while you're still delivering value is the best route to take. Mistake number 4 is protecting your baby. Have you ever had footage that you were super proud of? I mean, your pride and joy. Kind of like your baby. And you wanted to show your baby off to the world so they could see just how good it was? If you subjected your viewers to 20 seconds or more of the same footage because of how great you thought it was, do yourself and your viewers a favor. Slice and dice that footage down to 10 seconds or less. This gives your audience enough time to experience the emotion of the shot without losing interest. Remember that pacing thing we talked about before? Protecting your baby ruins pacing. The 5th mistake YouTubers make is letting people know their video is ending. When you thank people for watching your video, you're actually giving them permission to stop watching your video and look for something else to watch. You want people to watch your video all the way to the end and watch another one of your videos when the current video is done. I always try to smoothly transition to another topic, which motivates the viewer to click an end screen element, which helps them improve their video or avoid mistakes. You can avoid the 5 mistakes new video editors make by watching this tutorial. Don't forget to smash my cartoon face to subscribe, hit me up with your comments, and drop me a like down below.